Welcome. This year, CDH Education Inc. will provide you public speaking tricks and tips. And these will be very specific types of titles. So for this one, we're going to be talking about the elevator pitch. Now, have you heard of an elevator pitch? So what is an elevator pitch? Now, picture yourself being in an elevator and you are in an elevator with somebody that might be able to help you to grow your business or give you a start in terms of a job or a promotion. Now, would you know what to say once you got in that elevator? That's what this is about. So stay tuned, because this information will help you. Now, how can you use this information? Well, if you're looking for a new job and maybe you're going to networking opportunities like job fairs, or you are at a conference or a workshop, or maybe you're in school and you have an opportunity to meet somebody that you always want to work for. Now, let's say you're looking for a promotion and you get into that elevator with a superior in your department or at your job that can help you succeed. Let's say you have a business and you walk into the elevator and there's that bank manager or somebody who can help fund your business. Or let's say that you walk into an elevator and there's that client, that person that you really wanted to meet to make that sales pitch. What are you going to do? So let me ask you this question, and I want you to ponder this, answer it, and then put in the comments if you were correct. Now, do not lie. Make sure you tell the truth. Were you correct? So here are your choices. Is an elevator pitch a scheduled job interview developed in the amount of time it should take for a short elevator ride? That's roughly 30 to 60 seconds or 75 words. Is an elevator pitch a business funding presentation delivered in the amount of time it should take for a short elevator ride? Is an elevator pitch a mock interview delivered in the amount of time it should take for a short elevator ride? Or is an elevator pitch a quick summary of yourself delivered in the amount of time it should take for a short elevator ride? If you said D, you're correct. That's not to say that you couldn't use the others somewhat. But the bottom line is you are delivering quickly a summary of yourself quickly in roughly 30 to 60 seconds or 75 words. Can you do that? It's difficult, not easy, because you want to say so many things. So let's see how to get this done, shall we? Now, I'd like you to take, it's about 2 minutes, to watch this cute video, but it does bring the point across. And it don't skip the video, because it gives you an opportunity to see what to do or what not to do in a situation like this.
Yeah, no, last semester went okay. I'm really looking forward to this one a little bit more, but, you know, in a general sense. Operations is going much better than any of my other classes last semester. I'm looking forward to how that turns out. And, I mean, I just can't believe, especially, I mean, money and banking, please, you know, I do what I do. Oh, hang on. I'm in the elevator with President Oldham right now. Hey. And I mean, if you've got anybody in the college of business or anybody that knows, if you need a qualified professional, somebody that will actually get the job done well, then you know what? You know who to talk to. All right, so, okay.
Oh my God, hi, I'm
Hello.
Chris. It's nice to meet you.
Meet you, Chris.
Nice to meet you, President Oldham. I'm a College of Business ambassador, and I like art and painting and wakeboarding. My mom is like her biggest fan. Can we take a picture together really quick? Will you hold it? Take our picture? Your arms are longer.
Okay.
Oh, that's perfect. That's perfect. I'll send it to her. Okay. So, how are things? How's the First Lady, the kids? You know, y'all just say cheese?
Sure.
What are your plans as president?
Well,
What was it? Have you met Awesome Eagle? He's really cool. I like your shoes. They're really shiny. Do you shine them yourself? You're the president. I bet you have somebody to do that for you.
Of course.
You're just the nicest guy. This is my floor. I'll see you later.
Hey, President Odom.
Hello.
My name is Jessica Terrell.
Hi, Jessica.
I'm a College of Business ambassador, and I'm also on the speech and debate team. I have some great ideas that could really help this college. I know you're a very busy man, but I would love to let you hear them.
I'd love to hear them. I'm just headed to lunch. I was going to grab a quick bite. You want to go talk now?
Yes, thank you. I'd love that.
That'd be great.
So there you have it. You ought to be prepared in order to deliver that speech quickly. And as you can see, the final young lady did it, right? And so this is taken from the Indeed Career Guide. And these are the four-step elevator pitch. So first start by introducing yourself. Hi, my name is, it's so nice to meet you. Very quickly, provide a summary of what you do. I'm a PR manager specializing in overseeing successful initiative launches from beginning to end. There you go, quick and to the point. Third, explain what you want. I find the work your PR team does to be innovating and refreshing. I'd love the opportunity to put my expertise to work for your company. And then finish it out. And this is very important. Would you mind if I set up a quick call next week for us to talk about any upcoming opportunities on your team? And you might say a quick call. You might say, can I shoot your assistant an email? Whatever it is, the best way is to make sure that you haven't left out without establishing a point of contact to move forward. And all of that, in the time it would take to, let's say, get from one floor to another. Now, obviously, we're not saying that this can only be done in an elevator. You could do it at a business meeting. You might be in the hallway with the president. You might be at a conference, a workshop. You might be getting ready to eat at a function or a dinner that you've been invited to. You can quickly say these things if it is appropriate, if it is a business setting. So now, what did you learn? So you introduce yourself by saying, hi, my name is, and I'm completing a degree. Or you might say, so what did you learn from this very quick but very informative video? First, you learned that it's important to introduce yourself quickly. Hello, my name is blank, and I'm interested in whatever it is with your organization, company, etc. You start off like that, quick and to the point, very polite, very respectful. Step two is to provide a summary of what you do. I currently work, and if you haven't worked, if you're in school, tell them what you're doing. I'm interested in a career in, and the position, and the field. Very quick, again, very respectful and polite, but to the point. Three, explain what you want. I'm seeking a position, or if maybe you're in college, an internship, with your organization, and then explain your abilities. I've worked in college as and then you tell them precisely how what you do fits in with their organization. And discovered that I really enjoy working in the field, doing the thing, whatever it is. Or obviously, if this is a business opportunity, then you want to tell them how your organization will fit into the model that they have, maybe for the funding or the opportunity or the sales pitch. And then number four, you always finish. And this is the most important part, because everything else you can do later. This you cannot do later. Finish with a call to action. Would you mind if I sent you an email or followed up or called you or your assistant for an opportunity to speak about this more? That's your in. That's how you get to move forward to get your needs met. And so that was an elevator pitch. It's not always done in an elevator, but it is an opportunity for you to get in front of the right people to get the new job, the promotion, or the business pitch, or the sales pitch. So thanks for watching. Let me know if this was helpful and if you were able to use this. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care.